This is the day the Lord has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and play. They shall walk and not faint. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. God, who said, out of darkness shine light, and has caused his light to shine in our hearts. The light is knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Good morning, everybody. And welcome to all of you, those who are present and those who are online on platform in cyberspace. Nice to have you all. To our visitors, my name is Winston Lloyd Williams, director here at St. Matthew's, Kingston, Jamaica, West Indies, the best place on earth. The lessons for today, Isaiah 62:1-5. The Psalm is Psalm 35:5-10. The Epistle, 1 Corinthians 12:1-11. And the Gospel, John 2:1-11. Our worship continues on page 101. Blessed be God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Blessed be His kingdom,
Father,
forever. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Blessed Lord and Father, those assembled in your name and in fellowship with one another, enable such a grace to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, to proclaim and expand to the holy world. Jesus, I pray for your world and your church. Grant that we confess our sins. May we worthy offer you our souls and bodies as a living sacrifice. And eat and drink our spiritual food in this holy sacrament. Amen. Almighty God, to your hearts are open, all desires known, from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and bear the magnify your holy name to Christ our Lord.
You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord.
Father, for the second Sunday after the Epiphany, found in the front of the bulletin, also on page 160. We pray the prayer together. Almighty God, who saw our Savior Jesus Christ in the light of the world, grant that your people, illumined by your word and sacraments, may shine in the radiance of Christ's glory, that ye may be known and worshipped and obeyed to the ends of the earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with you and the Holy Spirit, lives and reigns, one God, forever. Amen.
The psalm appointed for this morning's service is Psalm 36, found on page 512, verses 5 to 10. Your love, O Lord, reaches to the heavens, and your faithfulness to the clouds. Your righteousness is like the strong mountains, your justice like the great deep. You save both man and beast, O Lord. How priceless is your love, O God. Your people take refuge under the shadow of your wings. They feast upon the abundance of your house. You give them drink from the river of your delights. For with you is the well of life, and in your light we see light. Continue your loving kindness to those who know you, and your favor to those who are true of heart. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be.
spiritual gifts, brothers and sisters. I do not want you to be uninformed. You know that when you were pagans, you were enticed and led astray to idols that could not speak. Therefore, I want you to understand that no one speaking by the Spirit of God says, let Jesus be cursed. And no one says Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are varieties of service for the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities for the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit utterance of wisdom. To another, the utterance of knowledge, according to the Spirit. And to another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, is of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, discerning of spirit. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are created by one of the same Spirit, who allows to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The bridegroom came is number 388. Stand up and bless the Lord.
Thank you. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine gave out, Mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what concern is that to you and to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you to do." Now, standing there were 6 stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 30 gallons. Jesus said to them, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the chief steward." So they took it. And when the steward tasted the water that had become wine, and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and then the inferior wine. Jesus did the first of his signs in Cana of Galilee and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Some of you have gone through already the actual
ceremony, but to encourage those who are thinking. Now, whatever church you are, whatever the minister is, whatever liturgy used for marriage, the basic reasons are the same. Natural instincts and affections. One, that children should be brought up and mutual society and comfort given to the one each other, both in prosperity and adversity. So each time I do a marriage ceremony and I have to read this part very long, I put it down, I just tell them to show them that three main words: relationship, companionship, and sexual satisfaction. And I always in counseling the people, I say to them, anytime two out of these three not working, then the marriage D-U-N. It's finished. Any three you want to make, anytime any two out of the three not working, then the marriage is doomed. Worse, if all three not working, and at that time it's dead for two. Companionship, relationship, and sexual satisfaction. Now, we can't just set a time and a day firm and then come to the minister. It must sort of be like a tentative date, that because the minister may have 10 other things to do. I just did one and two and a half, but I was the class, I don't want to know you. And the person comes and said, Father, the invitations are out and everything is there. Can you do the wedding? So, call the tender for us. I said, what the hell, sister? So, luckily when I checked my diary, it was F-R-E-E. So, now the time and the date must be of mutual consent between the person doing it. No, the size of the wedding. The size of the wedding. No, who to invite. And this is very difficult because sometimes, no matter how you try, somebody who you should have invited get left out, unfortunately. No, sometimes I just be on a practical note. I said to the bride, listen, let me tell you something, especially in a big size wedding, I said to them, listen, don't make my dress too long that you can walk tonight. And I'm amazed. 99 times of the big weddings, they can't walk in their dress. They might tumble down. And I have seen some bride come up, and when they come the aisle, the man must drop in front of me. Father. And I don't find it funny. But guess what now? When you listen to the minister, when you listen to the dressmaker, it was for me that was the kingdom. Oh, shit, I'm walking, I can't walk in my heart. So tell your daughters and your granddaughters and your granddaughters, don't make, sorry, just be practical. Don't make the move right to Burma either. Because the whole time you're going to say, why the pastor? So I had to put up one bill. When you ever finish, a poor pastor get blamed. Whether you wear the long dress and you wear the one shoes. Practical. You know, let me talk to that time, man, because, man, you know, see, so I fear if there was one and wife, I'm going to do that, a march on. Let's see the bride at home. They don't see the husband. See the bride. The two of them finished up and then gone outside and go out there. Where the bride come? And the husband out there come out beside. And the mother. However, go first, doctor, the mother next. And the way is things change. The bride is the queen of the day. Formerly, it was the man. It was the man. And I've said before, and then I said no, because I don't say it was not working. Formerly, the father of the groom would provide wedding clothes for all the guests. And after doing 500 at weddings, can you imagine if them just do that? How much would that happen? So we are looking on those who are going to get married, your daughters and your son, we want a new suit. Amen? You want one to that? Yes, thank you, your daughter, yes. And another practical thing, they serve wine, sometimes grapes, root juice, for toasting. For what? Toasting. But by this time, the wine, for the sort of the glasses, the man, the people just knock it back and it's done, finish. So when they said, when the toast person comes, please raise your glasses and toast to not a team or any glass. Shh. So when you go to the wedding and the wine is poured, it is for toasting. When the toasts have been completed, if any left back, then you consume the same. I don't want any member of St. Matthew's Church turn up at wedding and not after wine before you say that. Of course, practical guests must be seated by the host people there. Of course, things different on you. It used to be on this side, the groom's relatives, that side, the bride's relatives. But now, things different. It's not a big point, but I just point that out. The word MC, it has become a diluted word. The MC is the master of ceremonies, he's the master of the reception part. He runs things in calibration, the couple, as well as the minister. But guess you have no ideas. First time I was married, when they go to the wedding reception, they welcome the minister. No, they don't do it. I'll do it when I last night. I'll never them see me. And I was going to pack up my leaving and I said, no. They have this person, they call wedding planner. And I have no big go and ask the wedding planner. And I know she come and she up. And I sit down and I sat down and they cried. I said, I feel like going. She tell me about the food. And she don't want to, I said, no, it's be gracious, never know no better. So I grew up and I said to the father, Daddy, come with me. Because I said, you're going to meet your daughter at the door. And be like, because she tell all the prayer, the people them to come. And the father on the front, sit down. She didn't say to me, Minister, are you ready? She don't even have no. Same thing happened with some MCs. They don't see me. They don't see the minister. Let me tell you something. If you don't plan the wedding, and everybody come at the minister come, guess what? It can't go on. It will not go on. It reminds me of Bishop. Bishop Neville, the time when he was to be consecrated as bishop, when he drove me, the policeman said, you cannot come! You cannot come! He said, yes, sir. He said, nobody can't come. He said, sure. No. Nobody is a place for up. I was sitting there. I talk a while ago about knowing the signs of the remedy. And I like to tell the story and then I go into the Bible passage. A good member of my family, pregnant daughter, was getting married. And she said to me, "Father, I don't want you to be only to be the minister, but I want you to be the MC, the master of service." And guess what? Things are going on. And the rules. Mother came all the way from being Sidamo. A coast that was full of people, plus two cars. And we said, "No, I'm going to leave because there's no food here for my guests." So I said, "Father, wait, no. Me here run this thing, food there. Food is here. Don't go. You be embarrassing your son and your son's mother-in-law and worse-in-law and me. Make me some." So I said, "Go there, don't you stay right here, son. Shh. Mr. Man, when I go inside the kitchen," it was a home with him. When I push the door, the kitchen door was hard to move. And when I look behind him, you know the pot you serve at canteen, at school, the big pots, full of rice, full of gold, no, yes, 3/4 gold and chicken. And I said, "I'm going to wash up." So you know what I did? I said to all those who are inside, I said, "Look, what in the corner." And I said to a new crew, I said, "New crew, you come, you will serve." So I said, "Mother, stay right here." She said, "Give this mother whatever she wants. If she wants 30 bucks food, give her 30. If she wants 100, give her, because there was enough food." The lady in question, the mother of the bride, had provided for 500 people. We're not joking. The whole district as it were. And I said, "No, that is too many, because of the 200 people invited." So, to finish the story, this is classic. So I start to organize the new servers who will go this side and that side. So you want it, I said, "Father, come here." He said, "I didn't like dress this on." Every time they come with the waiter, the waitress will come. She takes someone, she has a bag underneath her dress. And she should take her, put her in the bag. So let's go and stand up beside the black dress lady. I said to the servant, "Don't come this side, go that side, all you good." Yeah, she said to me, "Father, I'm not getting none yet." And we said, "Well, you're not getting none now." Some people go to weddings to embarrass the guests because of their greed. And because of their unreasonable cleverness. So we go now to the story in John 11, John 2. Jesus at the wedding feast at Cana. What happened? Wedding ought to be a happy and joyous occasion. Jesus and his disciples were there chilling out, just relaxing, enjoying a little time off from the regular work thing, right? Chilling out, enjoying, you know, life, enjoying thing, enjoying social gathering. They're chilling out. No doubt, he was enjoying a joyous, happy occasion. What a wonderful thought. I wonder if you get it. Jesus was able to enjoy a joyous, happy occasion. Not like some Christians who believe that Christianity must be a time of gloom and sadness and black faces and can't laugh. I won't laugh. And if you, as a Christian, laugh, then get suspicious because you laugh. And yes, in the Bible, talk about the joy of the Lord is a strength. And Paul says, "Rejoice in the Lord." And again, I say, "Rejoice." And some Christians, how can you refuse to be happy and joyous with joys that you've given to us by blood that Jesus showed in this wedding feast. Just chill and light. So Jesus was sharing this happy occasion in this humble home. This humble home. Jesus never counted it a crime to be happy or to just relax. So we should not count it as a crime that we don't know what it is to relax and to smile. Let me tell you something. When someone smiles, when you look extraordinary, beautiful, you know. So someone who smiles, you're laughing. I mean, the time when it's classic smile, you know, some smile, you know, they laugh at 1 point, something like a second. As a smile from the world, you know, smile make you feel to the depths of your being. It will ease the tension. So then what happened at this wedding? We went in. This little village home, this little quiet place, this little humble home. It looked as if the crowd bigger than what they had anticipated. So then, great occasion, great crowd. It was in the form, a simple place, among the humble place. Simple and humble. Epiphany tells us that it is the manifestation of Jesus. So here in this simple, ordinary room, the time was coming once again. Or one of the times was coming that Jesus was going to manifest himself to this crowd. For Jesus, I want to use a place with nothing but the good, and that which is lovely must be present. That which is good and lovely must be present. What we say, what we do, and what we see, those things must be present. So what's up? Now, you know that in Eastern culture, hospitality was a precious thing, priceless thing. Someone puts it to a sacred. And one says, you must be careful, you might even entertain angels unaware. And then somebody, Jesus talked about, when do we see you hungry? When do we see you naked? The person asking Jesus that in the parable. So then, in this simple place, simple room, shame and humiliation were coming up. Shame, humiliation, embarrassment start to surface. What are the wine? Run out. The wine ran out. It's like the story I told. Bully my food around the corner. And then somebody crying out, the food finished. Which is not true, wasn't true. It would have caused at that way that I told you about embarrassment because of some scammers. And all the money that scam, not true. All the money that scam, that scam another thing too. But we don't know where they're going to go. Sorry, they're going to go. So here we see now Jesus, the one who's gracious and understanding, the one who's compassionate. He understood while others didn't, and I his mother, that the miracle was going to be done to the simple family to extract, to take away embarrassment, humiliation, hurt, and shame. So here we see that, what a beautiful picture. Here we see now Jesus now was going to act. He was going to use his power in the right way, the right manner. He was going to show off his power. He was going to act in secret and like with empathy. Because he knew what it was to be hurt, to be embarrassed, to be frustrated, to be humiliated. Note, Jesus had the power and he was going to use it rightly. So put now, look up. Mary had faith in Jesus, but she couldn't do that. She didn't understand. So she went to him and she said, things are not running now. Guess what? The wine went out to come. So, what is going on? Things are not, so they're going to happen to Jesus. The wine finished, man. Jesus had finished, the time finished. The wine finished. Mary did not understand what was going to happen. But she had faith. Faith, she said, alright. I have faith in you. One may feel that the request of Jesus to act was turned down. But look at it. Jesus said, my hour is that it comes. In other words, here again we see the one who has power was dead. Was what he used within his time, within his judgment, not because somebody else, another person is dear and close to him, but to command him to do, to act outside of the norm. Is this teaching us something that sometimes we want God to act out of the norm to satisfy our own ego? The ego is maybe in all situations. Will Jezebel be? Yes, it's real. It's real. But God's time, God's action, God's movement will always be different than ours. My time has not yet come. Somebody puts it, my time has not yet come. God answers prayers. No, yes, wait. And Mary, having prayed to Jesus, because prayer is talking to Jesus. Mary now, she turned and said, listen, whatever Jesus tells you to do, I'm going to do it. Just do it. Whatever he said, just do it, and she moved away. What a joy it is when we trust in Jesus. What a joy it is that when we continue to trust in Jesus, we prove him all and all. In spite of this fact that sometimes the situation is bad, terrible, causing embarrassment, humiliation, frustration, so on. Now, you have to remember that Brother John, writing his greatest theologian of all time, he was reflecting upon the story some 24 years afterwards. And every time John talks a story in his gospel, there's a reason behind each story. So what was the reason behind? First of all, it was somebody puts it, they said, 6 water pots, which was unusual. Normally, 7 was to be there. But 6 present. 7 is the complete number, as you know. God created in 7 days, and 7 days are one of these days. But John should be saying, listen, 6 water pots. Why not 7? And somebody puts it, said, 6 symbolizes incompleteness, imperfection. And he was pointing out, see what the dog was doing and is doing. The Lord is incomplete, imperfect. He simply said, hey, Jesus came, the perfect one, to fulfill the law and to move away from the law itself and to bring grace. To bring grace. The coming of Jesus is God's final act of grace. Grace in every situation. And I keep telling ourselves, all of us, we must try to be gracious in all situations. Yes, sometimes we fail and despise. But prayers must be, Father, I am sorry. Because sometimes we fail to be gracious. Even in some situation where others have fallen and they face humiliation and hurt, we fail to be gracious. Even when sometimes people seem as if life for them is hopeless and lonely and sad, and they turn to us, a shoulder to lean on, a person to call on, a person who knows Jesus as Savior and Lord, and we don't act gracious to them. We refuse to take the number of our eyes so that we can see the speck in the other brother and the other sister's eye. So when we are in despair, when we face humiliation, hurt, and embarrassment, please don't run from Jesus. If you are a real Christian, when you face hurt, embarrassment, humiliation, you don't run from Jesus, but you run to Jesus. You should run to the fellowship of Jesus. And this is why we as Christians, we must see ourselves as the body of Christ, the gracious company, the fellowship of love, so that people who are faced with humiliation, embarrassment, and hurt, and come and feel that in this hospital they can be cured because grace, God's grace, exists. So Paul writing, he says, hey, Jesus said, my grace is sufficient for you. My grace in every situation is for you. So notice, when you read John's gospel and his epistles, he keeps on talking about things like light and life. He emphasized those things. Life, light, and what? Light, life, water. He keeps on talking about so many of his stories. Light, life, water. So here now, the way I know now, which will come out of them? 180 gallons of water. I hear some of you people say, boy, I would love to be at that wedding. When 180 gallons, I hear you. For Jesus, he had the situation under control. Our challenge is to allow Jesus to enter our lives so that which seemed impossible will become possible. For the mother Jesus, it seemed impossible, but she had faith in him. What a wonderful thought if we would allow Jesus to allow the impossible things in our lives to turn them from just the ordinary to the extraordinary. So the water turned into wine was an extraordinary act, and it was done by an extraordinary and gracious person whom we call Jesus, who is our Savior, our Lord, our brother, our friend, our healer. Hallelujah. So the people said, including the MC, why the best wine? No. No, there are lots of things about that. I'm not going to go into them. Why people talk the best wine. But the best part of people's lives, the best part of people's lives was the last. The best part of people's lives, the last. So I took the son. Since Jesus came into my heart, what a wonderful change. Change in my life has been brought or wrought. So Jesus will change water into wine, and the water will object, resist, the water allowed Jesus to act. You and I should just relax and allow Jesus to so change our lives from just ordinary source of soul to that which seems extraordinary. We cannot go on so. We just have to go on so. So today could be your day when we ask Jesus not only to change the water into wine, but to change our lives into that which originally seemed impossible, that which would have brought humiliation and frustration. So guess what? So many people bothered about, quite rightly so, bothered about these things in life. And they are real. The Christian, the follower of Jesus, we are challenged to react to these problems, which are real, differently because we trust in a Savior who loves us with an everlasting love. So, get the text me. Tell me about all our problems. And in the back of my mind I said, yes, your problems are real, but if I ever tell her about mine, it will stop here, sir. And then she goes on with her text, she feels like giving up. And of course, to commit suicide, I understand the feeling. But if we should just remember, and if she could remember the presence of Jesus, who is able to change the situation. Maybe not right away, but we have faith in him. It is possible. So Mary said, what a man says, do it. And Jesus said, by my time, no, come, let, come, just hold on, hold on. What I said, I like the expression, your breakthrough is coming. Let me put it on the protest and say, my breakthrough is coming. God, wait a minute. Hey, come back, I'm going to sleep, come back. Come back, wait, shh, and come on. The world of perfect, so we're not problem. Shh, if you're like me, with various problems, and trials, and botheration, and grass, let me put your hand upon your chest. If you come, if you're like me, I said, my breakthrough is coming. All right. must say sorrow. They must say like in a bit. My breakthrough is coming. Let me give God praise. Thank you, Jesus. My breakthrough is coming. We need to have faith in Jesus. Yes, the problems are real. Some of them seem unsolvable. I said, where are these things? But trust in Jesus, please. Certain man begged me something, I closed up. And I said, we're broken up. Pass the camera! Oh, I'm crying. Because he lives somewhere in his family, he lives somewhere. When we say live now, and the mother believer, we live somewhere else. Since Jesus came into my heart, Jesus is how I trust in, how I prove in my word. If you want Jesus, if you want joy, let Jesus come into your heart. Your night, the darkness, will turn into day. Your sorrows, will drive away. And he wants to come into our hearts and stay, S-T-A-Y. So he stands and he knocks and he asks, please let me in. Please let me in. If you don't open up, you're not coming. Please let me in and I will come in. I am at your door. I know the problems beyond the door. I want to come in, exercise my grace, so that your life can be filled and made over anew. I pray that this morning, some of us face with all sorts of hurt, humiliation, and we feel frustrated and overstressed. Let Jesus come into your heart. He will change your sad, traumatic situation into nothing but good. And give you faith in him because you are willing and that's stronger. Since Jesus came into my heart, since Jesus came into my heart, floods of joy over my soul, like the sea billows roar. Since Jesus came into my heart, amen.
Night. Especially States of America with regards to the horrific Bronx fire. Pray for the families who lost loved ones and the victims still in critical conditions. Town Hall, which was hit by the tsunami after underwater volcano erupts. And for all people in their various colonies.
Together we pray, Almighty God, Heavenly Father.
we are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past. I'm glad that you will share the newness of life to the glory of God. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Page 125, 4b. If you are offering a gift at the altar, then remember that your brother, stroke sister, has something against you. You will give there before the altar, though. First, reconcile to your brother and come to him and offer your gift. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Shalom, once more. Amen. Peace.
Oh,
He presents you with the offering. Father, God, this gift of goodness is there in this life and in this world. With them, for life and the world, to come through the Spirit. As this bread and wine become the body of the flesh, so we are the children of the Lord,
which is in Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
His blessed master, the perfect sacrifice, then once for all upon the cross. His mighty resurrection from the dead. His glorious ascension to heaven. And with much comfort and glory, we are given this bread and this cup of salvation. We pray that our sins and sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, and rather than we eat and drink of the body and the flesh of the great high priest, may be ruled by the Holy Spirit, and be one body, one spirit in Him. Let faith and love increase in us. Unite us with bishops and the ministers of the word and sacraments. Lord, King of God, living and departing in whom you have made for yourself, confirm us in holiness, that we may be found ready to join the company of blessed Virgin Mary, the holy apostles and all our saints, when our Lord Jesus Christ comes again, forever to give thanks and praise. Through Him from whom all good things come from. With Him and in Him and through Him, by the power of the Spirit, we worship the Father Almighty with all the stand before the gentlemen to be sons of the last. Blessed be the man of God.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
Lord, also with
you. Let us pray. Almighty Father, we thank you for being us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May you share with the Holy Spirit. May you drink his cup of life to others. No matter where spirit shines, we light the world. Help us come to the peace of the world. So may all the children shine with me. Ministry of the hymn number 666. We invite the children to come. And anyone else who wishes to come for prayer, they're invited. And then praising all the little children. God is God.
Children, God is love, God is love.
And now we prepare ourselves for baptism. Let us be still so that we can experience God's blessing, such the ear of our being, our personalities. God, will the Trinity sanctify you. May God continue to surround you. May God continue to embrace you. May you feel His love surrounding you, His forgiveness ever assuring you. May you find Him victory amidst the storms, the stresses, the trials, the frustrations, the temptations of life. May you continue to run to Him, not away from Him, because He loves you and wants to embrace you once again and all the time with the love He offers us in His Son Jesus. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless you. Bless your loved ones, whether they are far, and keep you under the shadow of His mighty wings this day and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Let there be peace on the deep side. Thank you. say, Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You mean to say one more time, Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Now we just use the theme, son, for those of us who have not been here since. Let me repeat your theme, son. And our theme for this year ties in nicely with that song. Mission! Our mission, God's mission. Our vision, God's vision for us. Our purpose and God's purpose for us. So it's mission, vision, and purpose. So look at it. God to us. Us to God. People. God to us, vision. And our vision. To people and our purpose, God's purpose to us, our purpose to God and to the people. Amen? And that second sermon. Do you remember this one more than the other one? Yes, welcome to our view, those present here, and your visitors, glad to have you. Those who have received for a long time, very nice to have you. We are privileged this morning to have two gardens in church. COVID, the Prime Minister has not touched the object. People in fellowship. Amen. Today, we'll meet after service. Right, Miss President, the President, can't remember her name just now, but she will meet with them. Who are here. Alright. So, briefly. Next Sunday, please, is our annual congregation meeting. It's your meeting. Alright, we're going to make it as brief as possible so that we can still go. I'm hoping that we can make something to burn the gas. Amen. So please come to listen, and if you have any questions you want to be answered, it would be nice if you could write them to me or talk to me about them. It is better that you come straight, I write them straight, because sometimes when you go via the person that tells you to send the message, it dilutes or it changes. You understand? And so when it is answered, you say, but I saw you it said. Amen. So, we look forward. Please make every effort to just come and spend time. A little time. Amen. Also, please, Dr. Bunch with us. Sorry, Dr. Bunch with us. You see, men are older like this. We don't have any children, but she's still it. I have not received two activities for 2022, and that's it. Well, if you are late to join the confirmation class, see, tell Sister Angela, can I over there, sir? Your name, I'll give her a phone number. We should start shortly after the confirmation. We have at least 20 minutes on a Sunday morning, and then later on. We'll extend the time so that we can have a confirmation this year. Please note that the discussion about confirmation and baptism still going on. But we should have a commitment as to what happened. Okay? I am deeply saddened that nobody has responded. Please, not much I know, but one person. I have 1.5 persons have responded to the painting. So I'm told to announce that each paint costs approximately $2,500. And if you want, you can give the church the money. Alright, so that we can paint on. The office looks terrible. With the alarm, you call it water at the side of the shore. And we think there's another way to another church office. If you really want to figure out, I'm not asking Sister Marcia with you, as you need to get yours. If you want, please do it. Otherwise, if you don't know any longer, the name is Alec, write up with me to give some guidance. Thank you very much. Again, I exhort you, I encourage you to do all that you can to avoid COVID-19. And the other ones that were Father Baka. I am so sad to hear about your mercies who have been hit by COVID-19. Very sad. Sometimes we let go, we die, then we will catch up, man. Alright? Me personally, why I am so sad about it is, like I said, it's not some kind of way to see the cloud set up, you know, we never found the truth. And like the pumpkin up in the yard. You see the flower come off, shed was the pumpkin and come. Isa. And that's what he said, you don't see. And then he said, you can have it. And you don't know. And we come beside you and get it. And you go and write and go up and down. So please, listen to what the officials are saying and abide as much as possible. And nobody listens to them other than the taboo. Mark of beast and mark of wood and mark of this. And the government ever do something. That's why they want to come in the world. Nobody's afraid of me more than me. And we take my suffering. And I will take the other one. I should take the other one from there. But something and they said, look, I'm afraid of that. Something really happened. Every time I like something, but this week not going to pass because I don't want to go about this thing. One of my colleagues, and I call the name, caught it to catch it. Somebody knew it and I call it. All right, move it and I'll go very quickly. I'm going to make a little appeal to you. I don't want to call the bodies, the person, but one of our members, the young member, he has a particular sickness. And it's costing the family some good money. Alright? But his mother came to see me, and his auntie came to see me. I promised them that I will share it with you. So if you have a love gift to give to us, this young person suffering from this chronic disease. The mother said the first touch is $700,000. Just at first touching, and then the treatment after the first, next treatment now, and then they will go now, the treatment will be far. But it will cost about $235,000 for the next, just another touch. He's a young, beautiful young man, nice personality, and love him very much. And you've been at confirmation class, never afraid to ask questions. And when the mother tells them about all the things, some of these medical things we don't like to hear about them. Because we've started to fret But Jesus did say that the greater things you shall do. You know, some things that nowadays, you know, my dear young boy, they might give up a surgery, then cut you, not be good for a person, but I'm sure they're going to just push up, go up and I'm sure, camera. When they say camera, me used to be camera, so you know. So then, I mean, there's no one like this on camera. Anyway, it's scary. But anyway, seriously, if you wish to move to this fund, if you want to be the treasurer, just put television. This is for BP for you. No matter how little what it is, little you can feel that, rice basket. So I come to you for prayers, and I know that others of us have medical problems too, right? But I'm giving this one to you, and whatever you can towards this. Alright? Quickly! Uncle Youth Fellowship having their annual generation on Saturday, and the dinner council will be on Thursday, the 10th of February. The Anterior Mothers, you remember, we are joining the annual joint treat Saturday, the 20th. Right.
She Thank you.